Ok, es un día normal que llegamos a trabajar. Nos dijeron que había una alarma de incendio. Cuando ya íbamos en la puerta, nos dijeron que era ICE.
Federal agents yesterday arrested about 680 workers at 7 food processing plants in 6 cities.
Please put your heart. Let my parents be free with everybody else, please.
Authorities called it the largest single state action of its kind in U.S. history.
There's probably 20 cars back to back. I figured something was going on. Something ain't right, you know. Somebody ought to be passing somebody. And we ain't let you on premises. They went through everything. They checked garbage. I guess trying to find them, see if that's hiding, I reckon. It's just a mess, you know, really.
Las personas nos separaron, la raza morena y blanca de un lado, y los hispanos lo hicieron a un lado a todos, no importando si tenían papeles o no tenían papeles. Como nos llamábamos y de ahí, ya al terminar, nos amarraron las manos y los pies. Nos subieron al bus, nos llevaron al aeropuerto, no sé dónde. Nos poníamos nerviosos por si decíamos algo que no estaba bien o que si el papel que firmáramos era para que nos deportaran.
More and more people, father, immigration isn't our job. And I said, what is going on? And nobody knew what is going on. So at the beginning was a surprise. And then was like an earthquake or hurricane passed to the community.
Santa María, la Virgen Madre de Dios.
Growing up, we saw those kids' TV shows like Clifford, Blue's Clues. All those TV shows, they teach us like to treat people the same, that we should love each other, that like everybody's different in a unique way, but they're like still the same. And we should love each other, be kind and all of that. But then when we're growing up, it's not like that in the real world. There's shootings, there are raids, and then I feel like we're mentally not ready for that when we grow up.
Vine en el 2002 acá a Estados Unidos. Vengo de Guatemala, el lugar se llama Comitán, sí. Mucha violencia, poco trabajo, muchas cosas malas que pasan en nuestro país.
My dad is hardworking because he fights where he wants. Sometimes he gets rejected for it. He still does it and finds a way to provide for me and my family.
En ese momento pasaron muchas cosas en mi cabeza. Porque mi familia estaba en casa y no sabía nada de ellos.
About 18 months ago, we received a number of tips through a tip line that the Department of Homeland Security runs, alleging that there were unlawful workers working within these 7 different plants here. That initiated an investigation for us. We then went to the United States Attorney's Office and said, look, here's the evidence that we've collected that says that there are undocumented people that do not have authorization to work working within these plants. And therefore, you have the court's authorization to go into these plants and conduct a search to try to find evidence to prove that the company is involved in this criminal activity, which is hiring illegal workers. A lot of times what you'll hear when these activities happen is it was an immigration raid. It was not an immigration raid. Our enforcement operations on August 7th based upon a criminal investigation. All the people that were undocumented, that they did not have a legal right to work in the plant, they were all going to be arrested for working illegally, re-entry, or being in the country illegally.
Muchos compañeros de nosotros no regresaron. Cuando yo regresé, era la única, pero me pusieron un grillete para poder salir. Desde que nos agarraron, nos dijeron que tenemos orden de deportación. Hasta cuando un abogado tramite la que paren la deportación. Hasta eso, entonces, sabremos.
Mr. Miles, did you arrest any companies so far right here in this commune? Have you charged any of the employers? Have you charged any of the employers?
No, ma'am. Today we have not charged any of the
employers. You have not charged any of the employers?
No, ma'am.
Because if the employers who are really the root of the problem, don't have an incentive to hire the folks, then you're not going to have that problem. And it seems like that's a place you should concentrate your activities.
Representative Cohen, that is exactly what we're doing. We're not satisfied with going after the low-level people. But as I'm assuming all of you understand, it is a lengthy process to build a criminal prosecution. We serve search warrants. That's one step in the building of a criminal investigation.
Mississippi does not have an infrastructure to be able to handle this. Funds started coming into different churches. They turned their churches into legal clinics, spaces for humanitarian aid.
These people lost their job. They won't have income. They need to pay the rent. They need to provide for their family. Little by little, we start to build a program to have some kind of help for the people and say, we are here to help you. We won't abandon you. This is a very, now for Guatemalan, great moment for their daughters. They say mass and thanksgiving for the life of the girls, and then they have a celebration.
La paz del Señor esté con todos ustedes. Como hijos de Dios, nos damos un signo de paz.
The raid kind of took away like how I felt about the 15. I wasn't planning to have it because my dad doesn't really work, and so there wasn't really like a bunch of money that we could just like pop up and all that. And that's why I kind of like didn't have that excitement or like that happiness. Like I did enjoy it, I just didn't have like that feeling where like the other people had, where they say, oh, it was amazing and all that. Like I just kind of felt guilty for having it.
Que aunque estemos pasando duras pruebas, la mejor solución es unirnos y pasarla de la, olvidarnos de las penas para estar un poquito mejor.
It's beautiful, the resilience that my people are showing. I don't know how many folks here are part of the people that were detained. Like I can't count. But there's plenty, right? And they're here celebrating life.
Pues y los que lo soltaron, como en mi caso, pues nosotros sigue nuestro proceso de caso. No estamos libres todavía. Todavía tenemos el orden de deportación.
Estoy desesperado, no sé qué hacer aquí. Yo sé que no estoy en la cárcel, pero yo siento que estoy presa por esto que tengo en el pie. Yo necesito trabajar, siempre necesito yo de dinero con mis hijos.
Mis hijos son criados acá, todos son nacidos acá. Y llevarlos a un país, ahora sí van a ser inmigrantes como nosotros. Diferentes, diferente idioma, no tienen la misma educación en la escuela como aquí. Allá hay mucha perdición en las drogas. Yo creo que es llevarlos a un mundo que no conoce.
I don't know like what's really like the point to talk about it anymore in my head. I just feel like if we keep talking about it and talk about it, we just keep reminding the people that we should be scared. Instead of like talking about it, there should be more changes to it. There should be some action taken, not just like words. Because I don't think words are going to help anymore.
If you're in this country illegally and you committed a crime but entered this country, you should be uncomfortable, you should look over your shoulder, and you need to be worried.
Thank you.
not law-abiding people. They're violating any number of laws here in the United States. I'm not saying they're not good people. I'm just saying they're not law-abiding people. They are criminals. They are committing crimes. And some of those crimes have impact far beyond that chicken plant. I would imagine every one of them will end up getting deported.
That was just like the beginning of the storm in a way. We're just in the middle of it now. We're just kind of waiting.